Hey guys, this is Simon of the Tome Strombash, and welcome to the 10th episode of Groove Hunter. Guys, it's pretty amazing that we have already reached the 10th episode. It's a lot of fun to present the grooves to you, and today I also have something very special. So be sure to watch the video until the end, subscribe to the channel, and leave me a comment with grooves or fills you'd like to see in a future episode. Here we go. So last week we had a Marco Miniman performance here on the channel. His drumming is just incredibly good. And as a young boy, I bought his Extreme Interdependence book when it came out. This guy is crazy. So check out the interview if you're interested in. And the groove is based on two rhythms that are repeated in a specific order. The first rhythm is this one. One more time. And the second rhythm is this one. And one more time. So pretty similar, it's just one more eighth note, the second rhythm. And played in that specific order, and without the music, it sounds like this. Another great drummer out of the I can do everything in any timing, any shift, and also create a rhythmic illusion world is Gavin Harrison. Back then, when his first books came out, I think they're called Rhythmic Vision and Rhythmic Illusion, I ran straight into the store and practiced them like a madman. The groove that comes now is a pretty good example that it is possible to play ghost notes while playing cross stick. And what he does is a mix of soft rim clicks plus playing with his fingers. So it's actually something you have to get used to and feels a little weird in the beginning, but gives your grooves a very cool touch. So with Todd Zuckerman, we also have a drummer who is super versatile and one of my favorite rock drummers ever. Have you seen his solo on Dromeo when he starts with that tom snare melody? One of the most musical drum solos I've ever heard. And the intro groove out of the song Crash of the Crown is in a 5-4 time signature, while bass drum and snare drum play a rhythm in 5-8. So this is the ride pattern in 5-4. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. In the bass and snare drum pattern in 5-8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And if you put everything together, it sounds like this. And now, I'm very happy to announce that I was asked in a comment, "Hey Simon, can you maybe show a groove from yourself?" Of course I can! It is from the song Famous Last Words by my prog rock band Lake Cisco, with which we've just started a crowdfunding campaign. So if you dig our music, take a look at lakesis.co, and I'm curious about what you think. And with that in mind, thank you very much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this episode. Keep practicing your drums, and I'll see you again next big Wednesday in a new video. Take care, Simon out.